fucking high. Fucking Jesus with you. Hello everybody, this is a Jordansaurus Rex Norman. Welcome to what is the final part of Alien Isolation. Now that I at least have an inkling of where I'm supposed to be going. I also found out that is scripted. And he just went right back in the vent. Okay. So, I discovered, after watching... Fucking. Is there a vent behind me? There is no vent behind me. Alright, well, that's unfortunate. God damn it, with you, go away! I don't have time for you or your petty games. No, don't come back this way. Fucking tits with... What are you doing, big fella? What are you doing, big fella, huh? Burn it! Burn it in a fire! That's right. Alright, now that he's went back in bed. I discovered that this is here. This is a thing that I missed completely. Completely missed that. Oh! The screams of the damned are here. I love the screams of the damned. Come on, jam the data in there, Ripley! Where the hell? Oh, he dropped out of the vent. It's over there. Okay. Oh, God. Get out of here, you bitch. Alright, so now we have to go all the way back to where the generator is. Which is all the way back in the other room that I... Fucking high. Fucking Jesus with you. I literally can see that you are right there. But you're not gonna get me today, big fella. I don't think he's gonna get me today. I would like to think that he's not going to get me today. He's probably gonna get me today. Please go away. You know I'm here, don't you? You know exactly where I'm at. You know exactly where I'm at, don't you? Okay. I'm not moving. As soon as that prompt, if it pops up, as soon as the prompt to hold my breath pops up, I'm holding that fucker down. Oh, great! He went away. He lost interest. Great, that's fantastic. Please stay like that! Are we safe? He's over there. There's an alien to the left, but... Where? Who and when and how and why and where and when?
Evacuate station. This is not a drill.
I'll tell you what's not a drill. There's an alien right there who I don't approve of, mind you. Also, my hair is wet because I just got out of the shower. I think we're safe. We're not safe. This is literally the beginning of the game again, when I was stuck. Hello? Shalom? Shalom? Yeah, I wouldn't want to. Are we or are we not safe? I really have no idea if we are or not safe. I'm going to assume that we are. And I'm going to take a Hail Mary. Oh, yo, bitch. Where is he coming from? I know he's in the other room, but... Yep, nope, now he's in this room. Hey, how's it going there, buddy? No. Don't come over to my cabinet. My cabinet has a full amount of members. I don't have room for you. Oh, those black duck, those black, like, fucking. Hey, how's it going? Nice claws you got there. Go away, please. I don't have time for you. I have no need for you here. I have no want or desire for you to be here. Yep. Now where's it gone? Alright, I'm going to assume that he's abandoned me, temporarily. Fucking! I can do this once. Nope. God fucking! You are a bitch! I hope you realize that! We know. You said that multiple. Oh, he's in the complete opposite end. Watch as I say something. Come here, big fella. What the hell? I can't. Alright, good, let me save. Cram the data in your port! Climb, Ripley! He's coming in right after me, isn't he? Not today! I blew myself up. I blew myself up with my own Molotov again because the alien was a bitch and he decided to crawl in right after me. Come on, let me crank it. Crank it. Crank it! Go back in that vent, Ripley. Come on, big fella. Huh. Alright. I think I have a plan. One that does not involve being stupid. Well, okay, one that might involve a little bit of stupidity. Alright, I'm gonna try this. Go get that big fella. I have no idea if my plan worked, but we're gonna gun it. Fuck you! Oh, get me into that cabinet, Ripley. Take an intermission in this cabinet. Alright. We've got a calm. We're not calm, and we're not collected, let's face it. Let's face it, we're not calm, and we're not collected. I've been trying to get past this one part for the first... We're sitting at 25 minutes in this room. Thank you. Ish. There's not a vent above my head, is there? There not be. Yeah, go that direction, big fella.
After evacuation,
do not re-enter the station. Advise the orbital emergency container. Mm. I can't tell where he's at down there. I'm gonna have my Molotov ready. I will not be caught with my pants down right now. Okay, Ripley. Step at a time. Not right now! It's right over there! in the other room is where I need to go. Why do you have to be such a big douche? No, don't come in here. Yeah, yeah. Yeah? Are we clear? No, we're not clear. God damn you. Go away, you bitch. Where's he gonna come out? Let me save, please. Quickly, Ripley. Yes! Give it all to me!
Diane Verlaine of the Torrens.
Verlaine!
I'm attempting to dock on the tow platform below your spaceflight terminal. We can take survivors.
Verlaine! Verlaine! Get me out of this hell, please. Oh my god. You guys have no idea how stressful that one part of that game is. Because you have to run back and forth and back and forth with the alien constantly riding your ass into the ground. I will never forgive the developers for doing that to me. But let us go on. Find a way for the Torrens to dock. R.I.P. Sebastopol. Yes, please. Cram my data card into that port in that hole. Because I am not going through that shit again. I recognize this. This is all from... Oh? Ooh. Oh, I have to crouch to get under it. Of course I do. Because heaven forbid that I be able to just walk around freely. I'm assuming that I can... Fuck it. I'm assuming that I can at least stand and move freely, at least temporarily. Fat load of good bolt gun has done me. I mean, it would help. Yeah, I recognize this. This was very early on in the game. So. Yeah. Oh, use ion torch. Oh! See, yeah. Jesus, okay. So, yeah. Everything, it kind of comes full circle to the point where, it kind of shows you where you needed the tech, where it shows you in the beginning where you need the technology later on. And later on, oh yes, please. I'll take all of that juicy fuel. Sensor, anything else in here? No. strong arm.
Dallas, I'm about to broadcast the Nostromo report packet back to the Sol system before we hit the pods. The nearest open relay station looks to be Sevastopol. All things being well, you'll hear from us once we reach the edge of Sol. Don't miss us too much. Dallas out.
So yeah, this is the very beginning of the game, after everything has gone to shit. But, yeah, I do want to point out, I have not been using the tactic of hitting the wall and then moving away. Because, you know, there is a delay before anything will, you know, it'll hear it, it'll register it, or whatever, and then it will go after the noise. So I haven't been using that tactic, just because of... Whoa, Jesus Christ, I feel like I'm on walking on a tilted surface. I'm on fucking shrooms. I haven't really been using that tactic, just because, free the Torrens. Huh. Interesting. I haven't really actually thought about using that tactic, just because it's really risky. Like, yeah, granted, it makes a noise and it can distract something, but let's face it, the odds of me getting away from something that just comes charging up the stairs just to go in a vent that's upstairs. Oh, Jesus Christ. Verlaine! Verlaine! Verlaine, I'm here, Verlaine! Excuse me.
I repeat, Ripley. Verlaine, can you hear me? Are you close enough for radio contact? I'm here.
Ripley, thank God, I hear you. I need you to extend the dog cradle plant quickly. There are two. Should be close by.
Okay. I can do that, I think. No, big fella. No, big fella. Up. Think I'm gonna fall for your ruse? So, if I remember... Come on, get in there, Ripley. Preferably before something comes to chew and claw your face off. Dot cradle clamps, we need to go around the corner and it should fucking around down here, yes. I think. Period question mark? No. What was the point of that? That was a waste of time. Oh wait, no. Vent above my head. Duh. Ooh, hey. Our friend is back. Fantastic. Oh god, I don't like that. If I can get a good angle. Oh, okay. No, I don't want the shotgun. I want the flashbang. Shit. That. There's more than one. There's more than one. Fucking. How did they even get down here anyway? How did they even get down here anyway? That's. Oh, that's a bit odd, don't you think? Okay. Huh. Come on, please be an easy one so I can get this out of the way quickly. Yes. Yeah. Yes. Fucking. Fucking! Got it. Praise. Alright. Crawl back down here. Where I've discovered, apparently, that aliens can get down. Okay. That was a bit unnecessary. Oh, Jesus Christ, this guy did not have fun. Okay, so I'm assuming these wires are probably important. Charge pack. Molotov, that's really about all I can make. That would serve me to be useful right about now. I could make something else that needs a charge pack, but... I don't want to take that risk. So! At us. Reboot the system. Alright. While making all the noise in the world. Let's climb. Walk past a creepy guy who apparently killed himself smiling or some shit. Fucking okay. Ugh. Alright. Please be another simple one, and let me also not fuck this up. Aha! See, when I'm not being an idiot about everything in my gaming life, I know how this shit works. Kind of. Alright, so that's the link. What have you got for me? Utility. Initialize docking clamp.
Relaying, the docking clamps are engaging.
Okay, now
find the upper control room. Where exactly is the upper control room? Jesus. All right. Open. Probably climb out right into... Oh, that's compound B. Good, I need that shit. Alright. So, now, assuming upper control rooms go up. So that, why is everything on fire? I mean, granted, I know that we're ascending. Whoa, Jesus, I realize now that maybe Dante's Inferno was wrong, and that people actually ascend into hell. Nope, not walking into the vent. But I mean... Take that. I need that more than I need all that more than you do, probably, dude.
The personnel
I'm gonna save because I don't want to fuck this up again, or I should say the first time. Yay! I have. I have it.
Verlaine, there is no personnel umbilical. It's long gone.
What?
Wait. I think I can use the maintenance rig instead. If I can find an EVA suit, I can still get to you.
Be careful, Ripley.
Initialization. Operational. Alright, whatever.
That's it.
So, I'm assuming we now need to go back downstairs. Oh, get to the airlock. Yeah, the airlock is back downstairs with everything else. Okay, so... cool, let me save again. Nope. Of course not. That's okay. What the fuck? Hey, big fella, how's it going? Come on, aliens. Aliens, I thought aliens liked fire. Fire equals good, right? I mean, granted, you know, I have, oh, there's something over here I can search that I didn't see before. Nothing useful, but... there's something else over there I can search. I mean, granted, you know, if it gives me any flint or fuel, I'm not gonna... you know, I have enough to repel these bitches at least 2 or 3 times. But I don't have enough to just go spraying it all over the walls, like... Hey, big fella. Come after me. I thought I saw a second tail. I better not. Oh, that was his tail. Oh, that's a second tail. Can I kill 2 birds with 1 stone? Nope, I can't. When they both drop out of the vent. Come on, just kill me already. Thank you. When they both just drop out of the vent like that, it doesn't exactly bode well for my cause. Okay, great. Fucking high. Here we go again, big fella. He's just on fire! Good! I finally repelled both of them. There's more than one, though. Which means we need to keep our eyes and ears open. And listen for the sounds of my death. Which is very rapidly approaching. He's right above me, isn't he? Hey, friends! We are in a terrible, terrible spot, aren't we? Go over there! Please and thank you. Oh, yes, please. Thank God. That stress is over. God, I've been recording for almost an hour now. But... no! Okay, bye! That was great. But I had a feeling that that was supposed to happen. So... I've been recording for almost an hour now, but... because most of that was me dying in that one back and forth section where I had to restart generators and other and everything and some shit. Whoa, okay. Boy, they're trying to build another one of those things in a hurry, aren't they? More importantly, why are they building it on fire? I guess the aliens like fire, so... Ugh! Oh! Yeah, that's exactly what I would have said, too, if I did that. Hey, how's it going there, buddy? Not today. Not today. ID tag. Blair, I don't really have a use for that shit. Alright. Oh god, those things just fall apart violently, don't they? Alright. Is there any flamethrower fuel that I should be aware of up here? Yes. I see you. Anything up here? No. So they're building another nest in a very, very rapid hurry. And they're building it on fire. Which I guess just goes to show that aliens like fire. No! You're the only two. Good. Something tells me that there are more. Oh, I thought that was an unhatched one. I was gonna light the fucker up. Take both of those. I know why it's loading me up on the way. Fucking. Come on, Ripley, hurry. I know why it's loading me up on flamethrower fuels, because it's preparing me to take on those bitches. Ugh! God, everything is just so fucking wet. Ugh! Okay, so they decided to build their nest on like a fucking crippled transportation mobile, I think? Where? Alright, that's good. So... I know why it's loading me up on all of this flamethrower. Because it wants me to destroy the nest again. Which, you know, you all remember how well that ended last time. They escaped. Again, what? Hey! How's it going, friend? Ooh, that's a nice butt you got there. Okay. Alright, bye. It was good seeing ya. Have a good one. Great. So, we're not alone in this house of horrors. Aliens are here with us. And, whoa, again! They built their nest where the eggs are going to light on fire. I mean, granted, I know. For being animals, you know, they're trying to build a new home. Fuck this game! Ooh! That's gotta hurt. Okay.
That did not look fun. Granted, I know for animals, they're trying to rebuild their home. A lot faster than what most animals normally build their home. But, I mean, we're granted, come on. Fire? Really? Ow, that's fire. Come on, Ripley. Why is it? Seriously, I've never... Oh, hey, hi, Elvis, how's it going? Seriously, though, I've never understood why it gave me all the scrap. If I have... I have no idea what the scrap is even used for. Somebody could tell me. Since this is the final episode, somebody could please tell me what exactly the scrap was used for. That would be great. That would be fantastic. Right here, can I search you? Nope. Oh, nope, that's fire. Alright. Going down. Going down on the nice golden ladder of regality, I guess. Oh god, this is gonna be one... This is gonna be a lot of footage to edit. Hello? Ah, more flamethrower fuel. Yes, please. Again, I know why it's loading me up on all this shit. Alrighty, let's go. And you know, it was giving me a lot.
Jesus! Just let me make it through here.
Jesus.exe has stopped working! For fuck's sake! Oh, that was terrifying. Ish. I think I'm going the right way. I hope I'm going the right way. I have to be going the right way because this is the only way it looks like I can go. Yeah!
Fucking!
Too close.
I saw that coming a mile away. Yep. God, that really was cool. Oh, that's fire. Something's moving. That's a lot of blips. Alright, come on. Fuck you. Jesus fucking Christ on a motorbike. I fucking hate you with every last fiber of my being. Let me get to that door, please. Thank you. Ugh. He has a golem. That's ion torch shit. Flamethrower fuel. The fuck was that? Alright. I'm kinda curious. What part is Sevastopol will be even in? I don't even know. But. No, big fellas. Can I take this? Fucking! Ah, fucking! Light him up! Light him up, light him up! Fucking light it on fire! Light it! Fuck! I thought I got them all. Alright. Oh! This looks precarious. Oh! Yeah, I was right, that was very precarious. Alright. What do I do about this? The ladder went down, so I'm assuming if we climb down... ish? Period? Question mark? The station is falling apart. What? Oh, that's great. Oh. Hey, how's it going? What the fuck? Oh, hey, how's it going, friend? Not today, big fella. Take everything and climb, woman.
Verlaine, are you there? Please tell me.
Ripley, I thought I'd lost you. We're being dragged down from the mountain wall. The gravitational pull has twisted the ring and we can't get free from the station.
What do you need me to do?
Get out the airlock and EVA over to the maintenance platform.
Oh, we're on fire now.
Won't let you down.
Why are we on fire? What is going on? What do we do about this? I don't understand. How do I put this out? No! What have I done? What exactly do I do there? Do I just like make a run for it or what? Oh. What the fuck? Okay. Is this just gonna be how I start the entire- Yep.
Verlaine, are you there? Please tell me.
Come on, there we go. Yeah, I can see that.
Won't let you down.
Oh, save point, yes please. Let me cram my data inside. My vision is going really foggy for some reason. But I'm assuming that that's because of the alright, let's. Yeah. Ripley doesn't. Yep. Let's go ahead and use a different suit. Because I don't want the infected alien juices that it spit down all over the helmet on my body. Alright, let's go. Going out! Out we go! Into what I'm assuming is going to be what's left of this asshole. I don't know. I don't know at this point. But it's space, and holy shit, this entire place is falling apart. Jesus Christ, it's like fucking Requiem from Halo all over again. Jesus Christ. Alright, let's just get... Oh, my Lanta, that's a lot of space station. I keep seeing things, I swear to God. I kid you not, I keep seeing things. It just, oh, Jesus, like, they just go flying by. Some of them, like, they look like aliens. They look like pieces of debris, they look like people. They just, this, my life is just falling apart, let me tell you. Alright, come on, buddy. Oh, what the? Oh, there's a cart for me to use? Help me. Onward! Off of Sevastopol! Off of this hellhole! I mean, this lovely vacation spot! Ugh. I feel
feel like we're being followed. But I can't look any other direction. Oh, there we go. I feel like we're being followed. But I can neither confirm nor deny that claim. So, yeah, completely forget the fact that the door is operational. Which it probably, realistically, isn't, but... I mean, think of it this way. We're stuck in the EVAs, and we're about as slow as we were crawling, so, you know, very flatline, consistent pace throughout the entire game. You gotta be slow and stealth-like, and also not be a complete total idiot like me last episode, when I couldn't figure out what the fuck I was supposed to do, which took up, like, half the episode in and of itself, but still. Again, I feel like we're being followed.
I'm here, Verlaine.
What the? Hey, friend!
I see them.
No, you don't, because you were, looking... Hi! Keycard access! Yes, give me. Gimme, gimme. Keycard. Use the keycard, please. Faster. Ram it in the port. Thank you. Ram it in the port, thank you. Oh, hey, friend. What are you doing? You act as if you're not quite entirely sure what the hell to do. Oh, that's pretty. I would take a screenshot of that if I could, but unfortunately right now, we're having a little bit of an existential crisis with this damn alien that's over there, and I would like to at least get off of this station alive without dying a horrible death. Which, granted, let's face it, I probably will anyway. Also slightly concerned about how he can breathe. Set the airlock to auto. Famous last words, friend. Famous last words. Emergency dock and clamp release. Hey, I'm an engineer. I know how to press buttons and do shit that nobody else understands how to do. Let's go ahead. And this is reminiscent of the first movie when Sigourney Weaver had to pull the trap. Blow up the Nostromo in order to get rid of the alien. Or, get rid of the alien. Now, this is also taking very painstaking amount of time for everything to set. Come on, Ripley. I feel like there's just aliens standing all around me like, hey, what you doing there, friend? Are you ready to become our dinner meal? Yeah, aliens, just remember, this pizza is aggressive. This pizza will not be eaten readily. This pizza is very aggressive, and this pizza will fight to the death. Good. Alright, clamp. Gotta make sure we don't go flying off into space. Oh, alright, come on. Oh, hey, friend. How's it going? Oh, hey, friend number two. Hey, oh, hey, Mr. Alien number three. Hey, oh, hey, it's a family reunion. Press the button, Ripley. Come on. This pizza is aggressive! You thought that you were going to take me alive. Woo! Whoa, oh, that is pretty. I need to take a screenshot of that. That's a nice screenshot right there. That's beautiful. Bye-bye, Sebastian Hellhole. I feel bad for Ricardo being stuck in there, but... Okay, realistically speaking, you should not be able to have seen that, but, I mean, you know, that's just me. I mean, I'm not exactly the most scientific person in the world, but, I mean, you know, I passed every, granted, when I was in high school and middle school, I passed every science class I was in, but.
Verlaine, I'm on my way up to the bridge.
Yay! It's the end game. Meet Verlaine on the bridge. And, oh my god. Oh, this is very Nostromo-esque. because this is how it was set up when they were... Ooh, use. Alright. This is very Nostromo-esque, because this is how, this is almost identical to what the room looked like when they brought What's-His-Bucket back in, and they were experimenting on the facehugger that was wrapped menacingly around his face, and impregnating him with the alien baby. Great. So, can I not change? Can I not change? Door locked. Alright, I'm assuming that we're going on the secret bridge. Button. Ah! Why do you insist upon terrorizing me, you bitch? You bitches. Oh, now, again. You think you've got me cornered, so now you're being very meticulous. You're being very meticulously slow. Stick right. Okay. Come on. Use the button. No! This pizza is aggressive! And I will not be eaten. Oh, we're suspended in space. That's another screenshot right there that I need. I need that. That's a beaut. That's a beaut. She's a beaut. Come on, give me a good angle. That's a beaut. Oh yeah, that's a memorial screenshot right there. And she's alive. We made it off of the station. Oh, that's the end! No! No, that can't be the end! There's gotta be more! There's gotta be... There has to be more. Did that just say what I think it just said? Did that just say that this is Ripley? I don't know, but... Oh, man! Oh, that was... Oh, I... It's got
this is Ripley.
There it is. This is Ripley. Oh, that was so good. That was actually really good. That was probably one of the best. That was probably one of the best
Nostromo
horror games that I've ever played. In recent times. And I'm not saying that I'm not saying that every horror game is perfect.
Destroyed.
I know that every game has its own perks and everything, and I get that, you know, I'm still really relatively early on, and I will play more horror games in the future, and there will be good ones and there will be bad ones, but this, I thoroughly enjoyed this. Because the game it started off kind of fast paced because you could be a little bit more free about how you went and roamed around the station and everything. But once the alien threat was presented to you, you couldn't really get rid of it. And so you could start off really fast, but once you get the alien put to you, then you kind of have to slow down, and you really have to think about, okay, how do I use what I have in my arsenal to either protect, defend, either protect, attack, or distract, to be able to get from point A to point B, and just to be able to do the things that you need to do to get off of the station in general. And I think it could have been better. It could have been, like, right now, there could have been a little bit more clarity. About what her fate was. There could have been, like, I know, she's floating in space there, and she's in suspended animation because she's still in her EVA suit. And she's just floating in space after jettisoning herself.
This is Ripley.
And that alien. Into space off of the Torrens, which that's something else I want to know. I want to know how that alien got on the Torrens in the first place. I'm also signing. You know, it never really specifically says that Verlaine died. It never really specifically says that Verlaine was the one who that Verlaine was, you know, she got stabbed with the penis tail of the alien. You know, I kind of, for me, you know, kind of as a fan of, with games and a franchise like this, where the lore is a big thing, where the lore is a big thing, I'm a huge fan of the lore of any game. That's why I like, that's why I really like the Five Nights at Freddy's games, because the lore goes really deep, and it just, it drives, the lore is the supporting drive the story needs in order to go forward and function. As a fan of the lore and everything, I know that this takes place in between the first and the second movies, because at this point, Ripley Sr., Sigourney Weaver, is still floating suspended in space for another, I think, 20 or 30 years? Or something like that, until a salvage party finds her and picks her up. But that being said, I would really, going back to my point, I would really like to see a little bit of closure about, you know, what Ripley Jr.'s ultimate fate just then at the end of this game was. Like, if you've seen the second movie, or if you've seen the Alien movies in general, you know, it's passively mentioned. So if you haven't seen the movies, go watch them. They're really good. They're some of the best horror movies out there, for sure. But pardon me. But as far as Verlaine is concerned, that's something, like, right, Verlaine and that alien are concerned, that's something that I would really like, that me, as a fan of the lore, in order to just kind of put the last couple pieces, you know, into their slots in the puzzle, and where they need to go, that's me, kind of just something me, as a fan, would like to know is, what specifically happened to Verlaine, and how exactly did that alien get onto the Torx? Signing off. That's just me. That's a personal choice. Can I skip through these, please? Thank you. I don't want to watch the entire credits. God, I'm sure we'd be here for an hour in and of ourselves just watching the credits. I'm fairly certain a lot of people. Hey, my hair's finally dry. I'm fairly certain that a lot of people went into making the game. Yes, I get it. But, so were there any extras? Nope, just the credits. This has been, as of right now, one of my favorite series-based games that I've played. As of right now, my personal favorite, probably at this time here, at this point in time, is probably gonna stand to be The Legend of Korra, just because I thoroughly enjoy just the lore, just the story of that series, and the, you know, if bending were real, that would be cool. But this, as far as horror games are concerned, this will always be one of my all-time favorites. This is probably tied with Five Nights at Freddy's and that franchise. And then after that probably comes, I wouldn't necessarily call it a horror franchise. I don't know. I'm just rambling at this point. Ignore me. I'm an idiot. Completely forget anything that I just said. But, I think we finally brought closure to Ripley's story. And I think with that, this will officially be Ripley signing off. Thank you, everybody, so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Goodbye!
Final report of the commercial starship Nostromo. Third officer reporting. The other members of the crew. Kane, Lambert, Parker. Brett. Ash. And Captain Dallas are dead. Cargo and ship destroyed. I should reach the frontier in about 6 weeks. With a little luck, the network will pick me up. This is Ripley, last survivor of the Nostromo, signing off.